In this video, we're going to work on problem 1.3.1 from the textbook. Prove that 1 to the third plus 2 to the third plus so on plus n to the third is equal to n squared times n plus 1 squared over 4. Before solving the problem, let me go through the method of mathematical induction. Let Pn for n intercept of all natural numbers be a statement that is either true or false. Suppose that the following conditions hold. P1 is true. That means the statement is true when n is equal to 1. The second condition is for each k in n, if pk is true, then pk plus 1 is true. That means the statement pk plus 1 is true whenever pk is true. Under these two conditions, we can say that Pn is true for all n in n. Now, let's go ahead and apply the mathematical induction to prove this identity. To apply the method of mathematical induction, at first we're going to prove this identity for the case where n is equal to 1. And then we suppose that pk is true for some positive integer k, and then we use that to prove that pk plus 1 is true. Okay, so let's start with the base case, that is the case where n is equal to 1. For n equals 1, we see that the left hand side here is 1 to the third, that is 1, okay, and the right hand side is equal to 1 square, okay, 1 square times 1 plus 1 square over 4, and that is also 1, okay, so therefore the identity is satisfied when n is equal to 1. And this is often called the Bates case. Now let's move to the next step, that is called the inductive step. In the inductive step, we suppose that pk is not satisfied. So suppose that one to the third plus two to the third plus so on plus k to the third is equal to k squared times k plus one squared over 4, and this is true for some positive integer k. Okay, and now let us show that the identity is satisfied when n is equal to k plus 1, that is 1 to the third plus 2 to the third plus so on plus k to the third plus k plus 1 to the third is equal to k plus 1 square times k plus 1 plus 1, that means k plus 2 square over 4. Okay, so again, we're going to use this inductive hypothesis in order to prove that this is true. Okay, so let us start from the left, and we will show that the left hand side here is equal to the right hand side. So we have this. The left hand side is 1 to the third plus so on plus k to the third plus k plus 1 to the third. Okay, as you know, by the inductive hypothesis, this sum is equal to k squared times k plus 1 squared to the fourth. So we replace this by k squared times k plus 1 squared to the 4, and this is k plus 1 to the third over 1. So we can say over 1. Okay, so now the common denominator here is 4, so we multiply top and bottom here by 4. Okay, and then this is so we the common denominator is 4, and then from here you can see that the common factor of the numerator is k plus 1 squared, so we can factor out k plus 1 squared, okay, and inside of the parenthesis is this. This is k squared plus 4 times k plus 1. Okay? Now, this can be written as follows. K plus 1 squared. And inside here, we get k squared plus 4k plus 4. And everything is divided by 4. Okay. Remember that k squared plus 4k plus 4 is exactly k plus 2 squared. So this is equal to k plus 1 squared times k plus 2 squared over 4. And that is the right-hand side of this identity. So we have seen that whenever pk is true, pk plus 1 is true. Therefore, by mathematical induction, this identity holds for all k in n. Okay, so we finished the proof of this identity by mathematical induction.